Hello students, today we are going to discuss the 10th topic from our EVS textbook. The name of this topic is light, sound and force. So in this topic we are going to discuss all these three terms, that is light, sound and force. So first we will begin with the term light. So students, I hope you all know that light is a very important factor in human life. Yes, the light we get it from the sun. Yes, sun is the main source of light on this earth. Also, sun is the natural source of light. We get the heat and light from the sun without any cost. It is free for each and everyone who lives on this earth. There are many other sources of light that are human made, like candles, torches, then we have lamps. Yes, we have bulbs, we have tubes, LEDs, all these are the sources of light. But all these sources require electricity. The tubes, the bulbs, the LEDs, even our torches, they require electricity for their charging. So, these are the human-made sources of light. But the main source of light and the natural source of light is the sun itself. And we all know that we get abundant heat and light from the sun. So students, the objects that are around us, there are various objects in our surrounding. We can see them only when there is light. Suppose you enter into a room and that room does not have any light. It will not be possible for any one of you to see the things in that room. So light is very important so that we can see the things around us, right? So these objects which are in our surrounding are divided into two groups. So which are these groups? The groups are luminous objects and non-luminous objects. Now you might be thinking and wondering, what is this luminous and non-luminous? So I will tell you what are these terms actually. So here you can see the definition for luminous objects. Luminous objects are the objects that give us light. So definition is, objects that give us light are called as luminous objects. And the examples for luminous objects are candles, lamps, torches, bulbs, etc. Sun, it is a natural luminous object, right? The sun, it is not human made. It is naturally present in our atmosphere, or we can say it is naturally present in our universe. So sun is a natural luminous object. And these other things like bulbs, candles, torches, LEDs, all these are the human made luminous objects. The second term, non-luminous objects. The definition for this is, objects that do not give us light are called as non-luminous objects. So all the objects in our surrounding which do not give light to us, they do not have that capacity or capability to give light, all such objects are called as non-luminous objects. For example, we have pen, pencil, eraser, chalk, board, chair, table, all these, they are not able to give us light on their own. So they are called as non-luminous objects. Now I will be showing you a picture from your textbook, and from that picture we have to find out which are the luminous objects and which are the non-luminous objects. So students, here you can see the picture. This boy is standing on a ground, and this is the morning time. The sun is rising. Here you can see the sun is giving light. The light falls on this boy and the light gets obstructed. It gets blocked. So you can see here the shadow of this boy. How is the shadow? The shadow is long. So after some time, maybe it is noon, 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Here you can see the sun is on the top, right at in above the boy. So here you can see the shadow. How is it formed? It is very short, right? And now in this third picture, you can see the sun is resting. It is the evening time and the sun is setting. And you can see here, how is it again? The shadow is long again, right? So the size of the shadow keeps changing from time to time during the day due to the change in the position of the sun. The shadows are formed as per the position of the source of light that falls on us. And as I told you, a shadow is always formed on the opposite side of the light. Also, students, I would like to tell you that the moon, which shines in the sky during night time, it is a non-luminous object. The moon does not have light of its own, but it takes the light from the sun. Also, the stars that we see in the sky are non-luminous objects, right? A firefly, so a little insect which has light of its own, it is a natural luminous object, but the suns and the stars are So students, now let us move on to the next point, that is shadow. So what is a shadow? Shadow means reflection. In Marathi we call it सावली और हिंदी में हम उसे साया या फिर परछाई भी कहते हैं. सो हाउ इज दिस शैडो फॉर्म्ड? सो अ शैडो इज फॉर्म्ड व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट्स और ब्लॉक्स और स्टॉप्स द पाथ ऑफ द लाइट. सो अ शैडो इज फॉर्म्ड व्हेन द लाइट कमिंग फ्रॉम द सोर्स ऑफ द लाइट इज स्टॉप्ड और ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड बाय एनी ऑब्जेक्ट. देन on the other side of the light we can see a image, we can see a shadow. So the best example for seeing a shadow is, suppose you are moving or you are walking on the ground and the sun is shining in the sky. So if you are obstructed, when the sunlight falls on you, the light is not able to pass through you, you are obstructing, you are blocking the light of the sun to pass. And just then what can be seen? You can see on the other side, in front of you, you can see your image, your reflection, that is your shadow. So all the objects cannot form shadows, right? The objects which are which do not allow the light to pass through them, we can see the shadows of only such objects. But the objects which are made up of glass material, they allow the light to pass through them. And so shadows of objects which are made from glass material cannot be formed. Now also the shadows are seen on the opposite side of the light. Now I will be showing you a picture and tell you how the shape of the shadow changes according to the change in the source of light, or as the direction of the source of light changes, the shadow also changes to some extent. So students, here you can see the picture. This boy is standing on a ground and this is the morning time, the sun is rising. Here you can see the sun is giving light, the light falls on this boy and the light gets obstructed, it gets blocked. So you can see here the shadow of this boy. How is the shadow? The shadow is long. So after some time, maybe it is noon, 12 o'clock in the afternoon, here you can see the sun is on the top, right at in above the boy. So here you can see the shadow. How is it formed? It is very short, right? And now in this third picture, you can see the sun is resting. It is the evening time and the sun is setting. And you can see here, how is it again? The shadow is long again, right? So the size of the shadow keeps changing from time to time during the day due to the change in the position of the sun. The shadows are formed as per the position of the source of light that falls on us. And as I told you, a shadow is always formed on the opposite side of the light. Also, students, I would like to tell you that the moon, which shines in the sky during night time, it is a non-luminous object. The moon does not have light of its own, but it takes the light from the sun. Also, so students, a firefly, a small insect which has light of its own, in Marathi we call it काजवा. So it also has light of its own. So also do the sun and the stars, they have light of their own. So they are considered as
natural luminous objects, but the moon, it is a non-luminous object. And one more thing which I would like to tell you, the when you are playing on a ground and you are very much tired, what you do, you try to find a tree. When the heat of the sun is unbearable, you find a tree and you stand under the shade of the tree. The shade of the tree is the shadow of that tree. Okay. So students, on your textbook page number 68, you are having an activity to see the size of shadow changes with changing position of light. So you have to do it on your own. You have to take a water bottle and keep it on a clean table. And what you have to do is, you have to switch off the lights in that room. You have to make the room dark. And then take a torch and you have to light the torch over the top of the bottle. Here you can see, you have to do it such a way. So that time how will be the shadow, you can see. Then you have to take the torch from both the sides. From the right side you have to put on the torch, then you can put it from the left side, and you have to see the changes that happen in the shadow of the bottle. So I request all of you to do this activity on your own.